Today I'm going to cover a plant called Xanthoxylum. This Xanthoxylum Xanthoxylum asiaticum. It's quite a large group, this Xanthoxylum, and most of them have some interesting properties of like herbal and all, herbal properties, and also some are used in the culinary area. Then this particular one, this Xanthoxylum asiaticum, is also called Todalia, T-O-D-D-A-L-I-A, Todalia asiatica. Then that was the old name. Now it has been called as Xanthoxylum asiaticum. And common name is orange climber. Orange climber because these leaves have a kind of aromatic kind of mango citrus type of smell. This shiny beautiful leaves. Then this one is it's a woody climber. That is, it's called liana. Liana means woody, corky, thorny stem is there. That stem is hidden in this thicket, but I'll try to show it. So this is the stem. You can see, I mean, it's not that clear because it's thorny here, but anyway, that's the best I can do. That's the stem, and it has that corky nature. Then apart from that, it climbs onto trees, then up to 10 meters it's in. That means 20-30 feet. If you have some on the compound side and all wall side and all, it can be climbed on. And then thorns are not exactly the dangerous category thorns, but they are there. I think that's the thorn. Little thorns, I think, smaller than a rose and all. So there you can see the thorns. Yeah, that's the thorn. And leaves are not having any thorn or anything. Then shiny green citrus scented leaves are there, and yellow green flowers. Flowers, unfortunately, it is flowering is over, I think. So probably if I encounter this plant again in the future, in the season, I'll get the flowers. So this time we have to be satisfied with the leaves. Then fruits are orange fruits. So fruits also, I couldn't find orange colored fruit. I think most of the fruits have kind of, it is drying stages there, and then some are young. So I can come after a week or something and look for a orange colored fruit. Meanwhile, some remnants are there. This one, I think, is the orange, that fruit that has been eaten by some bird, I think, is the peel. Then, apart from that, let me show that berry. It has that small, kind of little more than the pea sized berries. This is here is one berry, that one. So finally it becomes orange color, and then it splits open. Those orange seeds, they dry up and it splits open, revealing a little black seed inside. That's the one. So this is the orange peel, which is having lot of that has a taste like I mean, this is a fruit peel that taste and has aroma like orange orange peel. Then that is a berry in between, hard thing. So that is a bit about the physical characteristics of this plant. This Xanthocyllum asiaticum. Then a little bit I'll tell about its herbal properties. It occurs in Africa, from Kenya, Mozambique, South Africa, and all kind of African places, as well as in a good section of Asia, that is India, Western Ghats, then some Himalayan regions, and then Burma, like that. It goes all the way up to Vietnam and all. And then it's quite a large family, so other species of the group also are there in all these regions. And this particular one, this Todalia asiatica or Xanthocyllum asiaticum, it is occurring in high rainfall zones on forest borders. Then like it likes a little bit of it can't just exist by itself in a hot sunny place and all. It's not one of those pioneer species and all like that, and it's quite rare also. So in high rainfall riparian forests you can find it. In India, such high rainfall forests are there on the west coast and then this Western Ghats region. Then also the roots contain coumarins, that's a group of chemicals which are antispasm, then antiviral also. And the plant extract, that is, this plant extract of course is a little dangerous way of extracting those herbal chemicals, because when you plant extract, the whole plant is boiled and treated and all, and they take out the essence of it, which involves destructive harvesting. If it's just a fruit or a nut or something, then the plant can survive. But if now they are using it as a plant extract, then the entire plant will be gone. And these are very slow species. They grow very slowly, and then they need long time to settle down and start producing fruit and all that. So whatever it is, this plant extract has been found to be a powerful antiviral and used in for H1N1. That is one of the dangerous viruses that is running havoc in the world, and then it is used for that also. Then apart from that, I think it has some culinary uses also. Those seeds, they are used in to make fish curry and to impart aroma to many of the traditional fruits. And then tribal peoples and then forest communities and all use it for antispasm and so many of the herbal preparations and all, it gets used. So this is an interesting plant. If you get it, it's worth having at least one of them. Then unfortunately I can't get a fruit sample to show it, so that the entire the species I could have done justice to it. But anyway, I've shown the berry already once. These berries. So that's a little bit about this interesting species called Xanthocyllum asiaticum.